all these stages are in the domain of Shariat, and they are for those people who walk in the light of the Shariat. He's referring to the various stages of the tasawwuf, of the spark of islah of the nafs. And he mentions here zuhud or wara or tawakkul or taslim or tafweez or riza or ikhlas or yaqeen. Ye tamam shara hai. These stages of zuhud, wara. Zuhud means abstinence. Abstinence means to renounce the dunya, to give up the dunya. And wara is a very high stage of taqwa, of fear of Allah Ta'ala. Zuhud, abstinence, zuhud are different stages, different levels of and degrees of zuhud. Therefore, the awliya, and then for the masses, but for everyone, for every moment, it is necessary to have zuhud. And the minimum requirement, or the minimum, the lowest level of zuhud, which is wajib upon every person, is to renounce the love of the dunya. Whilst we are in the dunya, you know, we participate in all the comforts and luxuries of the dunya, but there should not be love for the dunya in the heart. If there is love for the dunya in the heart, then there is no zuhud. That moment cannot have any zuhud. And the test for that is when there is a conflict with the Shariat and our desires. If our desires come into conflict with the Shariat, our worldly desires, our nafsani desires, our worldly motives, and if we give preference to our desires, put the Shariat aside, then that will be evidence for having the love of the dunya in the heart, and there's no zuhud in that person. But when there's a clash between the dunya, the needs of the these worldly desires, and the demands of the Shariat, in that clash, if you give preference to the Shariat, you set aside the dunya, then you will understand at least you are on the path of zuhud. But for the awliya, there is a different standard, and both these standards are to be found in the sunnah of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Once Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, in arat al-huqa bi falyakfi min ad-dunya kaza'at al-raqib. If you intend to join me, to link up with me, that way in Akhir, in the Jannat, I'm to enter Jannat the same time with me, if you intend, then you must suffice. Take from this dunya provisions which are sufficient for a person who's for a horse rider. He's on his horseback and he's on a journey through the wilderness, through the desert. So obviously you'll only take the little food and minimum provisions he will take with him. So you must take only that amount of the, be satisfied with the bare essentials, the thing of this dunya. وَإِيَّاكِ وَمُجَالَ سْتِلْ أَغْنِيَا. And beware of sitting in the company of the wealthy people. Also, if you sit in the company of the wealthy people, obviously it will have an asar, an effect upon you. Everything has an asar, have an effect, doesn't matter who and what it is. If you say, if you are in the company of someone, then it will have an influence upon you. So the effect of the takabbur, pride, riya, and haughtiness of the wealthy people will rub off onto you, so beware of the company, or their company. وَلَا تَسْتَخْرِكِ ثَوْبًا حَتَّى تُرَقِّيَهُمْ. And do not regard a garment to be old and to discard it, as long as you can patch it. Then patch it and wear it, don't discard it. This is this type of zuhud, the awliya, followed Islam, and there also the awliya, among them also there were higher and lower grades, different types of wara and taqwa they will have. One Buzrik saw in his dream, he saw two great awliya, now for this of the former times, Hazrat Sufyan al-Sawri rahmatullahi, and Hazrat Muhammad Wasi rahmatullahi. These were very, very great awliya of the early period of Islam. He saw in his dream, both had died and then he saw him. Then in his dream, Allah Ta'ala ordered the malaika, he must take them both to Jannah. So they took them, and when they came to Jannah, so the Buzruk, he was thinking, I want to see who's going to enter first Jannah. Of these two great people. When they came to the doors of Jannah, to the gates of Jannah, then the guards there, the angels there, the malaika, told Hazrat Sufyan Sawri to wait a bit. First, Muhammad Wasi will enter. So Hazrat Wasi was entered first. And when you say enter first, the separation could be a long period of centuries. A delay for entering. Like the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to the Sahaba, this wife of mine, Aisha, she will enter 500 years before many of you, 500 years she will enter before you into Jannah. That is because of a faqr, a poverty. She lived an extremely poor life after the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So because of that poverty, she will enter 500 years before many of you, of the senior Sahaba also. So the delay there is is great. Not a matter of a few seconds, you wait out, one go in and then the next one follow. Not like that. So the Buzruk was surprised. Why? Such a prayer, it was acknowledged by all the awliya of the time and ulama understood that Hazrat Sufyan Sawri rahmatullahi. His maqam, his degree, his rank was far greater than that Muhammad Wasir al-Dalim. But in reality, the ranks are only known unto Allah Ta'ala. But he was known here in the dunya, as the Sufyan Sawri al-Dalim was known to be the greatest of his time. So this Buddha asked the angels, the Farishta, why? Why was Hazrat Sufyan delayed? Why was he kept outside? Why did Hazrat Muhammad Wasi? Who isn't he greater, his rank, than Hazrat Wasi? So the Farisha told him, the angel told him, yes, his rank is undoubtedly the rank of Hazrat Sufyan, so is higher than the status of Hazrat Muhammad Wasi. But the reason for him being admitted first, Muhammad Wasim, is that Hazrat Sufyan Sawri rahmatullahi had two sets of clothing, two sets. And Hazrat Wasim only had one set. He didn't have a second set. When there was a need to wash his clothing, he would wash one at a time and remain inside and then get it dried first and then wear it. So because of that zuhud of it, He must be admitted first. So we find there are different stages also in all these different degrees in all these stages of Zod, Tawakkul, Taslim, etc. But there's for the message, there is a minimum degree. And the minimum degree for us all is that there must not be love of the dunya in our hearts. Understand the thing. This love for the dunya, it destroys a person. The whole Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he told the Sahaba one day, he told them that the time will come that the people of the dunya, the nations of the world, the kuffar, they will make a meal of you. They will call one another to devour you. Now you have to alliances. They'll form alliances and coalitions, and they will devour you, they'll eat you all up. So the Sahaba asked, Ya Rasulullah, Nahnu min killatin yawmaitin, Yeah, so will it be because of our few numbers of the time? So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, but no, on that day you will be in abundance. Your numbers will be abundant. But you will be rubbish. You will be rubbish. Kahuta is saying, you will be like the rubbish, the flotsam which the flood waters bring down. You will be like that. And Allah Ta'ala will then, what he do? He will take out the fear for you, which now the kuffar have for you people, for the sahaba. He will take that fear out of their hearts. He will take out that fear out from their hearts. And he will, in your hearts, then the hearts of the mu'min, Muslims, Allah Ta'ala say, he will create one. So sahaba, ya Rasulullah, what is one? Not one. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa karahiyat maut. The love of the dunya, and aversion, hatred for mort. Mort must come. Every person has to go, and we must make preparation for mort. No, we cannot put it out of our minds and pretend that we are never going to die. Our actions, the manner in which we conduct our lives, our attitudes, It creates the impression that we are not going to die at all. So, and hubbu dunya, love for the dunya. So as long as there is love for the dunya, because of this love of the dunya, you will become like trash. And this kuffar will devour you. This is what's happening all over the dunya today. You see what is happening to the ummah today. It's because we have become trash. We are the love of the dunya. It is has filled our hearts. The Shariat, Allah Ta'ala's deen, has got no value. If there's a clash between our desires, our dunya, our worldliness, and the deen, then we set the deen aside. We set the deen aside and we give preference now to the dunya. So that is now evidence for not having any zuhd. And it is all that level of zuhd, it's wajib for every mu'min to not to have love for dunya in the heart. Wa akhir zaman, alhamdulillah.